locker room. It'll be a pleasant offseason for them. Well done. Down the stretch, they were just about perfect.
I think they were perfect in all areas and led by a guy who probably played as good a football as a game of football.
Three games, Minnesota, the Rams, and this one. The performance by Joe Montana was just almost unbelievable.
You know, he doesn't want to talk about being the best because he said, you save that until your career's over. And he said, I don't think that I'm over. I don't even think I'm close to being over.
He hopes to play, he said, until he's 40.
How would you like to be a kid getting a piggyback ride from your father off the field of a Super Bowl victory?
You hear me? I stayed the house.
Isn't that something? The MVP of the Super Bowl, he has to go in and fix his own chair in the locker room?
Three times. The MVP. The final score again. The 49ers 55, the Denver Broncos 10. You've been watching CBS Sports coverage of Super Bowl 20.
49ers keep their date with the history books. In one of the greatest football games ever played by one team, they become the first team in the history of the National Football League to win back-to-back Super Bowls since the Pittsburgh Steelers. What an unbelievable job! And owner Eddie DeBartolo gets the winner's treatment. And now, really in keeping with this new dynasty, what a pleasure it is to bring in the new commissioner of the National Football League, Paul Tagliabue, to award the Vince Lombardi Trophy. Paul?
Brent, nice to be here on a special day. Eddie, I know you're wet, but let me just say this. Today, the 49ers finished their trip to becoming one of the elite teams in the history of the National Football League. You've won your second straight Super Bowl game. The team did it in dominating fashion, as you've done in the playoffs, as you did it throughout the season. You've won your fourth Super Bowl in a decade, even less than a decade, tying the Steelers as the only team in the history of the league to win four Super Bowls. And you are clearly, at this time, the 49ers are the team of the decade, and they're starting the 90s looking like the team of the 90s. I want to congratulate you. I want to congratulate all the players, Coach Seifert, and your entire staff. Congratulations.
I know you guys think that I'm all wet, and I am. First of all, I want to congratulate Pat Bowlen and Dan Reeves in a fine job that they did this year with the Broncos. They really had a great season. But to you men, I want to say one thing. Back in July, when we traveled to Tokyo, we had a mission, we had a quest, and we have one hell of a football team, and I love you, God bless you, and thank you for being world champions. And thank you to a man that came in a very, very situation that wasn't exactly easy, and he is your coach, Coach Seifert.
Yes, exactly. Thank you.
George, while you were coming up here to the stand, I want you to know that the first thing the players said, the first thing when they came in, they said, three-peat, three-peat. They've got the heat on you already.
Well, so, we're so happy and proud of this football team. There's no question about it. I'm happy for them that they were able to achieve this goal. And if they want to go for another one, that's fine with me.
George,
I'm so happy for Eddie, and I'm so happy for all the 49er fans too, and all the people in San Francisco.
George, did you ever think it would be this easy when you were looking at the films and the plans? 55 points. This afternoon, you had it against Minnesota. It was 27-3. The Rams, 21-3. These games were over at the half.
Well, I think as a football coach and as a football team, you give plenty of respect to your opponent, and none of these games are easy. We've played three great teams in these playoffs. They would have had to have been great teams to get to this point. So we're just proud of the effort of the team, this entire organization, and I'm proud of the teams that we played against, and I'm proud of this team, obviously.
George, congratulations. Eddie, congratulations. And we're going to continue live from the San Francisco 49ers locker room in just a moment. Jerry Rice. Joe, congratulations. Third time you've been the MVP. Your buddy Jerry got it a year ago, but this was some performance. You really looked pumped up when you were introduced to the crowd. I said, wait a minute, Joe's ready here.
Well, I think we all were ready. You know, there was a lot of talk about them, and there had been some things that happened out in the streets that they weren't talking to us, and I think that helped to motivate our team. And I'll tell you what, our offense was executing, and I'll tell you what, our defense just shut down another great offensive team, and that was two of the biggest keys.
Jerry, tell us about your two touchdowns. The first one, I know Steve Atwater tried to decapitate you down by the goal line.
Yeah, he really wanted to knock me down, but the thing I tried to do, just focus in on the football, and I was able to really keep my balance and get into the end zone.
Yeah, and then the third touchdown, as we roll that up, describe that for us.
Well, Joe is the best, and he drilled the ball in there. And the thing about that, I knew that Atwater was getting ready to hit me, so I just held on to the football.
You know, Joe, it is absolutely remarkable. The ball is so catchable when you throw it. I mean, these guys take it on a run, and they'll take a 5 or 10-yard ball. They'll turn it into a 50-yard gain. We've talked about this.
Yeah, that's one of the great things about our guys, not only our wide receivers, but our running backs. We're not afraid to give them the ball short because they've got some great ability to run with it after the catch. And, you know, they've been showing that all year long.
Tell me about your offensive line and what they did for you.
Well, I mean, I think I might have got touched once. And, you know, I don't think I got sacked down the stretch, and they just had one heck of a ball game. And, heck, I could play to 140 if they play like that.
Hey, Jerry, can you become the first team to make it 3 Super Bowl championships in a row?
I feel we can. We got a great team, a great organization, and I'm just looking forward to next year.
You looked like you had a great game plan defensively right from the start. In fact, I think John Elway appeared to be confused right off the bat.
I think what happened was we were able to just make sure that we contained him in the pocket. We wanted to try to not give up the long pass. And I think that first pass that he threw early in the game, it was a little short, and I'm not sure why, but it was just one of those things that I don't think he was really on today.
Yeah, everybody said before the game you would like to keep him in the pocket. And if you made him run, try to make him run up the middle.
That's true. We wanted to keep him in the pocket. We wanted him to run up the middle. And also, we didn't want to give up the long pass. We felt coming to this game, after looking at some of the previous games, the reason that they were winning was because of the long pass.
Let's talk about Joe Montana and the adversity of the week. You told me that it really had something to do with the way your team played today.
That's true. All the players just rallied around him. One of the things that happens is when a player of his caliber is being ridiculed or being thrashed in paper, we try to rally around him as a family, and we know what Joe's about. We understand what he's about. It's crazy for people to think that he's had a drug problem, that he even used drugs. Joe's a great family man, and he's really dedicated to our team. And the guys just said, look, let's go out and rally around him, and let's win it for him.
You also said there was some antagonism towards some of the Denver players.
That's true. Early in the week, I guess Larry Roberts and Don Griffin and a couple of other guys went out, and some of the Denver players didn't even want to socialize with us. And that was really tough because, I mean, you're here to win the football game, but when those things happen, it means war, and we just want to take it out on each other.
And Jim Burt, turned loose by a team they didn't think he would ever play again after winning a Super Bowl with the New York Giants, and now he is in the San Francisco 49ers locker room with his young son and the Vince Lombardi trophy. Let's go upstairs now to Pat Summerall. Out again for San Francisco. 55 points, the most ever scored by a team in a Super Bowl. Roger Craig, congratulations. You seem to get better and better. You're really up there with the elite runners now in this league. You're fabulous.
Well, thank you, Brent. It's been an outstanding year for us all. You know, we never got down on ourselves. There's times when they were downgrading our offensive line, saying they were finesse, and they just took up on themselves to make it happen for us. You know, you win ball games up front, yeah. And they did an outstanding job.
Well, your buddy Tom Rathman got a couple of TDs. Talk to me about your score here in this Super Bowl.
Well, you know, it's so strange. I thought Danny Stelvett scored, and I was talking to somebody on the sideline. You know, I had my helmet off, cutting my tape off, and they said, we have to go back out. I went back out, and, man, I didn't know that I even tied the touchdowns, you know, as far as the Super Bowl record, and that was unreal. It was a great one to finish the day off with.
Can you make it 3 in a row next year, Roger? I'm putting the heat on.
Three-peat. All right, 3-peat. Here we come.
All right. Meanwhile, Roger, we want to go over and check in again with Street. The NFL has had a romp through the playoffs quite like the San Francisco 49ers and their rookie head coach, George Seifert. They put their names up there on the honor roll. You know, the Green Bay Packers started it, and then they said there'd never again be a dynasty quite like the Pittsburgh Steelers. Well, the San Francisco 49ers have certainly answered that. They, too, now have won it 4 times, and next year they'll try to become the first team to win 3 Super Bowl championships in a row. And don't count them out. We'd like to say thanks to a great crew for a wonderful job today. So long, everybody.
come out on the field in front of the Packer bench to snap Vince Lombardi in his moment of triumph.
And the Jets are champions of the football world.
A 32-yard field goal by Jimmy O'Brien.
He fires the middle, intercepted, and the end zone kicks off.
But they caught Bannon up and in into a yawning chasm in the middle of the defense.
And Bowers beats out Perry.
Montana looked to Rathman, hits Rice. Rice scores for San Francisco.
The guitar. We're gonna have fun down here.
Rice, touchdown.
Goodbye, Joe. Me got to go. Me, oh, my. Me got to go. Pull the bureau down the bow. Jambalaya, crawfish pie, a filet gumbo. I said tonight, I'm gonna go see Mama cheer me up. So goodbye, Joe. Me got to go. Me, oh, my. Me got to go. Pull the bureau down the barrel. Having fun drinking rum. Me, oh, my. A little bit of stew will fit for me and fit you too. You see the little girl that's dressed in blue and waving her hair. She's been around a long, long time. Look at that.
Okay.
I said tonight I'm gonna go see Mama cheer me up. So goodbye, Joe. Me got to go. Me, oh, my. Me got to go. Pull the bureau down the barrel. Having fun drinking rum. Me, oh, my. A little bit of stew will fit for me and fit you too. You see the little girl that's dressed in blue and waving her hat.